did it ahead my way. Run is am dumb, agus quirum felta aras quig spooky house. And now, hi. Thank you. Clearly, I needed a cattail mustache after all of that. I did just hi. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Oh, jeez. So I got home and I figured I would do a shopping bag mailbox video. So there's a clip that I took shortly after I got home. I got home, I put my bags down, I took off my jacket and put it up on the door, and of course, this one, little Murnau, he decided that to crawl inside one of my bags, that would be the crossbody bag that I use in addition to my backpack, and then what happened, because he could smell catnip toys in there, I went to the store, I got them their cat food for hopefully between what I picked up today and what they still had can't remember. I think that was, oh shit, yeah, back around January. December, Random Acts of Pet Food People, I just was like, hey, it's kind of a tradition that my friends get my cats more stuff for Christmas than they get for me. Unfortunately, a lot of my friends were broke, so I was just like, hey, if anybody wants to send the kitties cat foods, that would be a huge help. Cat food and litter and all of that. Hi. And so we just now got down to the last bag a couple weeks ago. There's still enough to take us another couple more weeks, maybe. Hopefully. That would be nice. So I finally went and bought them pet food, and we got some, just because it is an extra broke month, thanks to Isaac's minions that are being evicted, and there is one more spray in a couple weeks, and then what happens is hopefully they're all gone. I have not seen any since the second spray. That is nice. Knock on wood and all of that. So then what happens is, because it's an extra broke month, because it was literally some of the cheapest food at Petco, and you know they've switched to like all natural, so like no fillers and all of that, so per the pound we're looking at about $1.60 ish, roughly a little under that, somewhere around there. So I got a 14 pound bag of the Rachel Ray Nutrish because we could also get a multi-pack of the wet food, and they have a lot of wet food right now. Not a lot, but they've got enough wet food right now to get through the rest of the week. So this other packet, I think it's 12 small tins or little cups, whatever. So it's like 12 small cups, so that'll be another, just a little under 2 weeks. And, because of the way I mix it. And, I will switch my default, Amazon wish list to the, or, I'll switch my Amazon wishlist for this video to the cat's wishlist if you want to get them more wet food, because they go through a lot. But hi. Food stamps renew in about 4 days. I can get them tuna on food stamps to help us get through the month if necessary. And so I got them. I also picked up a couple little toys. One catnip toy is over there. The big catnip eggplant, insert clip here. Uh-oh. Did kitties find new toys in my bag? Uh-oh. 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 Where'd the scissors go? Right here. Right here. Hey, that's... crap. Okay, so that's not actually a terrible balancing act I've got going here. So, let's see, and let's cut that off. So, this one says Little Paws, but it's a teething toy, and Nigel likes to chew on things. That's Phoebe. Nigel bag! Nigel. Hmm? What does Nigel want? Do I need to spray it with catnip? Does Papa need to spray it with catnip? Oh, oh, oh. Nope, nope, he's got it. He's got it. Oh, oh, and Phoebe's got the eggplant. Oh my gosh, it just occurred to me. That probably, you internet people, you probably think that looks worse than it does. Nigel, bud. Nigel. Want your chewy toy? Want your chewy toy? Oh, there he goes. There he goes. And then there's a chewy toy over there. Nigel likes to chew on things. And this is another treat toy. So you put treats in the little jobbies, in the little tubes on here, and the cats will like chew on it. They're supposed to chew on it to squiddle the toys, or squiddle the toys, not the toys, the treats out. And where did their treats go? I don't know. But, you know, worst case, I can, you know, just spray this down with some of the catnip spray, and Nigel will chew and chew and chew, and he likes toys to chew on. He really does. Also picked up some cedar and lavender sachets from, what's that place called? Bed Bath & Beyond. Because I've noticed bed bugs are not fans of cedar. Most insects are not, which is good. And plus, cedar smells really nice. And why are there all these bags attached to this bag? So, at Michael's, while I was waiting for the bus, I decided to stop in there, and they had this was the one that was on a coupon. So, I've got the lamp in my bedroom area that needs a new shade. This is smaller than that skirt I got from the thrift shop that I wanted to turn into a lampshade. I'm going to see if the skirt will put up with anything I can do to make it fit on here. If it cannot, I will research my other options, which I might just go with paper or... Ooh, no, wait. I can get some... I don't know. I can probably just do something with paper. That's a very, plus I use the LED bulbs, so it's generally, flame proof. But yeah, paper lampshades are a very, very early 20th century thing. So we've got a lampshade cage here. I thought I could make one out of wire coat hangers, but ideally I would want something to form things with, right? I don't know. I tried several times with wire coat hangers that are free at one of the thrift shops, but then what happens is, I don't know, things just didn't work out. So this is what I picked up on eBay. Cherry Berry, some kind of number, 48. I don't know. She, Cherry Berry, some kind of number. She sent me a nice wad of cash that she was hoping would go toward a chest freezer for my kitchen, which I still intend to get one, hopefully this year, but I was in desperate need of new underwear because I've dropped little over 20 pounds. I thought 25, but I'm a bit stable at around the 20 mark right now. It's not ideal, but it's doable. That's a little over a pound a week since January, so not bad. That's a little under 2 pounds a week since January, right? Because we're only not just a little over a week into April, and I started counting January 9th. So yeah, 3 months, 20 pounds. 3 months is 12 weeks, approximately. And yeah, a little under 2 pounds a week. Not bad. A lot of my underwear are a combination of too small or literally falling apart. Like, I had about 3 pair that, I don't know, I was dyeing. I had some leftover purple dye after I did my jacket, so I just threw all the white ones in there, because a couple of them, you know, they weren't looking so great anyway at that point. I'd had oh god, when did I get that package of white low-rise? Oh god, 10 years? That makes sense that they're falling apart then. Yeah, because I remember it was maybe a year or so after my first surgery, so that would have been, no, like 11, 12 years ago. Right, yeah, I've had that. Basically, there was like 4 pairs of underwear that I had a little over 10 years. I have thrown away 3 of them because they were literally falling apart. Like, one of them was like, you had the waistband, and the back was like, and another one is like, there's a little leg band, and big hole up the back. And, I like the low rise because I'm 4 feet 11 inches tall, and the regular rise, the high rise, they come over my navel, and like, even when they are the right size, which I am at about a 36, which, yeah, that's a little on the bigger side for someone my height, but still, it's like, I like the low rise because at my height, like, I'm not even 40 yet, and I've already got, like, you know, I've got a couple of the regular high-rise jockeys, and seriously, the waistband comes over my navel, and I'm like, no, I don't need grandpa waist already, because, like, when I'm grandpa age, they're gonna be up to my armpits, and it's like, no. So, low-rise, highly recommended for anybody under 5'5", honestly. It's like, I remember seeing my father in the regular rise, and he was 5'5" most of his adult life. I think he was getting down to almost 5'4" by his last couple of years, but that's It's just, like, the way your spine compresses from gravity. So, yeah, I highly recommend that you go with low-rise if you're under 5'5". Just because you will feel like a normal-sized man. You won't be a normal-sized man, but your underpants will let you feel like it. Might still have to wear ladies' jeans to, you know, feel like you're an average height, but... And now... No. Okay, so, something else came in the mail today. So, Cherryberry 148, whatever. I will recognize her screen name when I see it. And she's been very, very eager for me to pick this up. And she said that she got some kind of notice about something or other in the tracking info for this package. At least I'm assuming this is one that she sent to me, presumably from my Amazon wish list. So yeah, the address on here, this is not where I live, 200 East Liberty. If you look up 200 East Liberty in downtown Ann Arbor, you will notice this is the post office and federal building, isn't it? So that is a thing that I use. That is an address that I use, that I can use, because I get a P.O. box. And, oh my gosh! This is another pet carrier. So, let's see, I could... What fell? I'll figure it out. It's a plate from last night. So, it looks like this is, maybe the cat's wish list is already the default one. So it looks like we've got a beautiful purple carrier that, I don't know. Oh, wait, no, it's been used enough. I can't take that back. Phoebe's already stress-peed in it, so... I will have a secondary carrier then. So, we've got this beautiful purple carrier. Oh my gosh! So... smells like new plastic. Oh, that's what I needed to go to Joanne for. I needed a new zipper for the space bubble. Okay, so we've got a panel that goes down, and it looks like... I should be able to... Oh, and it's got a Velcro here, and... Okay, yep, I should be able to take this out so I can wash this pad... When this stress piddle sometimes. It's a fairly average thing that cats sometimes do. So we've got this beautiful purple carrier here with a couple of pockets. Oh wow, this is actually much nicer than the one that we've already got. So. Okay, so we've got a little clip here to secure them to secure to the collar while getting on a harness or something, and there's a shoulder strap. I'm familiar with these, and we've got one pocket here for putting treats into, and then there's a pocket here. For putting treats into. And then there's another zip here. I don't know how that's supposed to be useful. And another pocket here. Oh wow. And what's this zip about? I don't know. Oh, Okay, so I don't know what that's all about, but I'm sure it comes in useful for some people who like to figure shit out. And then there's this side that opens up a little bit, so like a little tiny dog can stick its face out, but we don't want to do that with a kitty, because kitties are wily, and they will like leap toward freedom and maybe jump in front of a car, and then we will be sad because kitty will be flattened. And another pocket here to stick a water bottle or something. And yeah, this is actually pretty nice. Is that it? Okay, so yep, we've got a big strap here, and another strap here, and a couple of clippy-doos to secure something like a little cat-sized yoga mat. Maybe a blanket. And, oh, this is beautiful. This is so beautiful. Thank you so much. Oh my gosh. Yeah, we'll see how this works, because I put one up on the cat's wish list, because Phoebe needed a carrier. Like, we've got a hard shell one, and I don't like those. I don't like those. I don't like the hard shell carriers. They're a bit bulky, so they're a little bit more cumbersome to store when not in use. So that's a thing. I mean, yeah, the space bubble's got a hard shell, but it actually, like, all folds up into itself. Plus, it's a backpack. and you know, purple, it goes with half my shit. And this actually has, like, a really nice, stuff on here. I can probably put pins and shit on there. Oh gosh, thank you so much! Thank you so much! Oh my gosh, I'm gonna... hopefully the cats will, crap and stuff. They will not crap and stuff in that. I've never seen them stress poop. They've stress peed. They've stress peed, which is a lot easier to deal with. Or at least it is... It is easier to deal with, because... With that, I just bring it home and I nature's miracle the hell off the bottom and sides of it. So this is not from today's or even the weekend's shopping bag. This was from a shopping. I don't know. I didn't do a shopping bag video about this, but this I got at Joanne a couple weeks ago. It's a little blank cross stitch. Thing. It says it's a bookmark. Now I like the paperboard bookmarks because I can demonstrate here with this postcard. I can read the lines like that. So with this, I'd have to fold the lace down and all. But so I posted to Instagram today. I did the Ankh freehand without a pattern. I just kind of like eyeballed it, and yeah, it looks generally okay. I might see how like an extra row of cross stitch on there goes. I'm going to get a pencil and finish putting out this letter P. Why a P? Because it's going to say Perky Goth. And I thought after I was, like, this far along on the P, I'm like, oh shit, maybe I should have had grid paper to, noodle this out and see what works. But hopefully it'll work. So I was gonna do the perky in the block letters, and then, goth in a, I've got a metallic, black that I want to do, you know, in kind of a cursive script. So it's going to be like, you know, the lines on here rather than the full cross stitch blocks. I might try to do a spider, I don't know. I'll see if I can do some spider web pattern up around the top rows of that. That would be nice. Otherwise, oh, here's cat treats. Sitting right next to me. Interesting place for cats, for cat treats. Okay, so these are not grain free, but so, you know, like the cat food I just got. But on the good side, Phoebe's only reaction to grain food, grains and food, is she gets gassy. So while that can't be comfortable on her, thankfully though, the only grain in this new cat food is rice. It's brown rice. So then what happens? And rice is indeed considered a grain. So, Nigel sees a treat toy. Nigel butt. Okay, let's see. Hey, love. What do we see? Okay, let's see if he goes for this. Because they do like to get their treats out of toys. A lot of cats actually seem to be a lot happier when they have to, you know, like, work for their treats. So, treat toys are an ingenious thing for cats. Like, they've had them for dogs a lot longer, so it's really good idea that somebody finally decided to just, like, scale down the basic design so that it works for your average cat. Granted, Nigel is still much smaller than most dog breeds, but he's about the size of a small Cocker Spaniel Actually, there's a Jack Russell in the neighborhood that Nigel is certainly bigger than. It's hilarious. There's a couple dogs in this building that Nigel is bigger than. To be fair, one's a Pomeranian, so. Was there anything else that I picked up? Let's see. Half and half is in the fridge. Coffee syrup. That doesn't need to be refrigerated. No, I think this is it. Other than, there is something that I do want to show off, though. Okay, they've knocked over the big-ass thing of poster board. But over here, we've got a, it's not showing off the best, but I don't feel like walking around the coffee table right now. But, so that is a blank doormat. And, oh my gosh, that is actually going to be a great size to make a stencil for that. So, okay, so I'm going to make a stencil out of this big-ass poster board for the blank doormat. And then we've got indoor-outdoor textile paint. Hopefully, it's enough to, spray through the stenciling. And if anybody would be interested in seeing cats all over things, of course you're interested in that. Why else are you watching this? So if you're interested in what I draw and cut out for that big-ass poster board size stencil for the doormat, leave a comment and all of that. And I might do a how-to video at the very least. I don't have the grandest setup for that kind of thing, so I'd probably just, like, you know, like, first I'd draw the stencil, and then I'd show it off, and then I'd cut it out, and then I'd show it off and show you my X-Acto and everything, and give a brief, quick breakdown of pricing and shit, and then I'd, I don't know, probably hold my phone like this and, like, print. So, yeah, I don't know, like, leave a comment, hit the like button, if you'd rather, hit the dislike button. It doesn't really affect my, my things either way, and, still gets me the recommendations and all that. If you want to, feel free to subscribe, if you want to, if you have not already. If you have already subscribed, I've just broken 1,000, subscribers, yes. But unfortunately, they want me to have 1,000 subscribers for a minimum of 90 days. Oh my gosh, why? I guess in another 3 months, I can start live streaming again, unless somebody wants to get me a webcam, I don't know. I've got a Patreon and all of that, and, you know, or there's the PayPal tip jar if you just rather, like, toss me a buck here or there. Apparently the cats have a wish list on Amazon that is already listed there. I don't know. Well, they've got a wish list on Amazon either way. And we all know the real reasons you are watching this is for Nigel Butt and Murnau. And where's Phoebe? Up my butt and around the corner. No, she's not up there. She's some... Oh, there she is. She's under the coffee table. She's over there. Miss Phoebe. Phoebe girl. Hi. Phoebe, we see your lasers. We see your lasers, Phoebe. Phoebe. Please don't eat the jade. Please don't. I swear to God, cat. Please stop. Stop. Not for kitties. Phoebe. Thank you, Missy. Thank you, Miss Missy. Miss Missy. Miss Missy, Miss Phoebe. Missy, Miss Phoebe. So sweet and pretty. Phoebe girl, what we doing? Are we sweet? Very much so. So, now that we've bothered the cats, best parts of every video, right? Is the animal bothering minute. So then what happens? I don't know. I've got a couple ideas for Wednesday's video, but I'm probably gonna go with, you know, until I can live stream from my phone again, or somebody wants to get me a web camera. I might find one at the thrift store tomorrow, but I'm not gonna spend too much time out at the thrift shop tomorrow, because tomorrow is Witch's Night Out at Crazy Wisdom. And that usually means a Crazy Wisdom shopping bag video. Probably nothing too extravagant this month, but, stuff and nonsense. I don't know. It's an extra broke month, but, I don't know. Maybe, I don't know, if I can keep it under $15, we might have something interesting. I don't know, but then what happens? Crap and stuff. That should go on a t-shirt. If that goes on a t-shirt, please buy one so that I can, I don't know, like, buy more cat food. That's where my budget goes every month. Because Phoebe has very expensive dietary needs. She needs to be grain-free or she will fart all day. She does, too. It's hilarious. Oh my gosh, these pills are so late. And I'm about to have coffee with them. It's like alcohol, right? Mmm. Okay, that filling did not go in very well. I have to call the dental school about that. But yeah, coffee is like alcohol, right? Like, if you... Like, you know how if you cook with alcohol, most of the alcohol burns out? So, like, if coffee has sat there for a good, like, 8-9 hours, the caffeine has, like, evaporated, hasn't it? Hasn't it? I don't know, it was just a sip. And I'm listening to Enya. Wednesday's video, until I can live stream again, that is probably going to be my review of Tears of Suns by Victoria Kopis. It is part of the Raythu Mythos series, which is the Raythu series being originally by Storm Constantine. She has since brought a nice collection of other writers into the fold, writing on a fair amount of other Raythu stories, and even a pagan tradition of its own. So,
right, Kitty?
Right. Kitty knows. Kitty knows. And, I don't know, I'm probably gonna go back right now to watching, the YouTube videos from, I don't know, like 2 days ago at this point, I don't know.
Right? Right? Oh, isn't Mother now so happy? So happy with new cat toys? Yes?
I could get some of their older toys out of the box, but, I don't know, they've got a couple catnip toys that they have completely deflated, and I don't know, it's just kind of work to put new catnip in, and find a place to sew up the seams. But, I don't know, there's probably a couple toys they've got that I could stand to throw out because of the stuff. And you're going to fall, Cat. For now, you're going to fall. He's going to fall. He's going to fall. Nope, okay. Nope, you see attention. You see attention! You see attention! Oh my gosh, why does this cat love me so much? Damned if I know. You know why you love me so much? No, you just know that I give you love and foods and spanks and in exchange for all of the spankins and the lovins and the nommins, you are so cute and stuff. Yeah, but Nigel's my boy. Nigel's my sweet lover boy. Nigel, but Nigel. Nigel is so cute. He's beautiful. As is Mirror now. And Miss Phoebe. And are we happy? Yes. So, now we say goodbye to the people. We say bats and kisses. No? Okay. So, bats and kisses, sweethearts. And I do love you so very much. And slán.